Hi everyone. Once again, I am presenting one topic of Java language. It is not so advanced topic of the Java. It is data type. In every language, data types are required. First of all, you have to understand that what is the need of data type. Basically, for that purpose, I want to switch my screen to my board. And then you have to understand first in which way the human brain is recognizing the types and what is the utility of that. Exactly in the same way, the computer is not intelligent and IQ of the computer is zero. So before applying any operation or before going for any operation, we have to clarify to computer that what data type is this. So just I am switching my screen to board, and then you have to try to understand that what exactly data type. So this is NetBean. I think today we will not be covering anything in NetBean, and I will be telling you so many calculations and so many computations related to that. But I think we will not be making program. If we require, then naturally I will be using this one. So this is my board, and you can understand that what exactly data type. Just see one example. When I am going to multiply, when I am writing 5 multiplied by 2, 5 multiplied by 2. Then my human brain or a human brain can understand it. Human brain can understand that 5 and 2 can be multiplied and I can write the answer of that is 10. Exactly in same way, when I am writing 5 plus 3, then my brain or a human brain can understand in which way 5 and 3 will be added and answer will be 8. If I am writing 5 plus 8, then human brain knows the 5 and a both are of different category. 5 is one number and a is one alphabet. So addition of 5 and a will not be possible. So I will be writing in mathematics 5 plus a. If I am writing a plus b, then human brain can understand a and b cannot be added in such a way as I am adding 5 and 2. So I will be writing a plus b. Okay, so exactly in same way, when I am going to perform the same type of operation by my computer, then it will be very difficult for the computer recognizing. But some languages are there in which we are not mentioning the data type explicitly, and computer will recognize, and that compiler will recognize, or you can say that software will recognize that what data type is that, like 5.0 and 5 only, it is one character also. So all will be recognized separately. But particularly in Java, when I am writing a program like C++, then I have to clarify that what is the data type or what is the type of data, whatever you are writing, that is to be explicitly mentioned, then what is the category of that. Now you can see one more example, like when I am multiplying 5, 25 with 25, then you will be seeing in which way I am multiplying 5, 5 is a 25, so just I am putting 5 here, 5 to the 10 and plus 2, so it will be 125. Now you are multiplying, this will be 50. Now you can write 625, answer is 625. So what are the rules of multiplication for integers, then you will be getting the 625 answer. But when I am multiplying 2.5 with 2.5, then you will be seeing all the rules of multiplication like integer will be applied here. So I will be writing 125, I will be writing 50, and then I will be writing 625. 5. So you will be seeing, just I am shifting it to this side, and now you can see it very clearly. 625 I am writing, but answer is not 625 in the case of floating point multiplication. So what I have to do here, I have to finalize the place. I have to finalize the place of decimal in this case. So I am writing 625, 6.25, because one place is this one, one place is this one. So finally, I have to put the decimal on this place. So now rules are changed. There is a very small change in the rules of multiplication, as the rules of multiplication are available in the case of integers. Okay. So what change? Just we will be applying all the rules of integer multiplication in addition to the place finalization of decimal. So just I am finalizing the place of decimal, and it will be 625. So now this is float and this is integer. You can understand it. So there is a small slight change in the rules of multiplication. Just in addition to the rules of integer, I am putting one more rule, and that is finalizing the place of decimal. So I think it is okay. So due to that, a computer require that you have to mention, or I have to mention explicitly, that what is the place. I have to mention the data type, like we are mentioning in C, C++. Exactly in same way we will be mentioning here, particularly for integer, int. For integer I will be using int, 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 and variable name is I. For float I will be writing float, float, j, and this one semicolon. For character I will be writing char, and I will be writing ijk here, like that. So this is the syntax to declare one variable integer, this is the syntax to declare one variable float, and this is the syntax to declare one variable character. So in that way we are going, and we are declaring the variables, and we are declaring that data type of each variable. I told you what is the need of that, because when computer is seeing, then it will be selecting a set of rules, what type of rules are to be applied for a specific operation, for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Now one more interesting thing I am going to tell you about that. Before going in the detail, I want to tell you different data types. So if I am dividing just at the top level, then there are two categories of that: primitive data type and non-primitive. There are two main categories of that. Particularly in non-primitive data type, we are seeing class, array, and you can say interfaces. So there are mainly three categories of that. In primitive, you will be seeing there are two main categories. One is numeric and non-numeric. Okay, in numeric you will be seeing integer and floating point. In non-numeric you will be seeing byte, non-numeric you will be seeing character and boolean. So just I am moving it to this side, you can see it very clearly. Data types, in that there are two categories: primitive data type, non-primitive data type. Non-primitive means object and non-object, or you can say primitive or non-primitive. This is object data type. Primitive, non-objects. Now, in primitive data type, you are seeing there are two categories, numeric and non-numeric. Numeric will be having two types. One is integer, another one is floating point. Now, in non-numeric, character and boolean. So, this is the complete categorization of Java data types. Now, in the next one, I will be seeing that now I have to see not only categorization in that way. Now, further categorization is also possible. This time I am going to categorizing integer. Integer. So, there are many different categories of that. You can see an integer, you are seeing the first one is byte, the second is short, and third one is int, and fourth one is long. So, there are four categories of that. Now, in each one we have to know about the size of that. So, byte, it will be taking 1 byte. Short, it will be taking 2 bytes. Integer, it will be taking 4 bytes, you can say 4. And long is taking 8 bytes. Exactly in the same way, if we want to categorize the floating point, there are mainly two categories. One is float, number two is double. In float, we can say what is the size of float? It will be taking 4 bytes. And double is taking 8 bytes. So, once more I am repeating that integer has four different categories: byte, short, int and long. It will be taking only 1 byte, it will be taking 2 bytes, 4 bytes and 8 bytes. Floating point, there are two categories for that: float. Now, in which way we have to represent? What is the syntax? So, for byte, I will be using byte like x, like this. So, this will be the syntax to use byte data type. Same short y. For integer, you know very well, int b like this, and for long, long, long. You can say C. For float, I will be using float, for example F. For double, I will be using, you can say double, D O U B L E, double P, like this. So, in which way I am going, in which way I will be declaring the different variables of different data types or different categories. Like for byte, I will be using keyword byte. For short, I will be using short keyword. For integer, I will be using int keyword. For long, I will be using long. For float, I will be using float. For double, I will be using float. For double, I will be using double. Now, I want to tell one more thing. As I told you, there is a non-numeric category also. So, in non-numeric category, there are two data types: non-numeric. There are two categories. One is boolean and another one is character. So, boolean will be taking only 1 bit and character will be taking 2 bytes. Now, for boolean that is okay, but for character I will be using syntax char and c. This will be small, character C. So as I told you about all the data types and character, there is a big question, why character takes 2 bytes? There is a very big question that why character is taking 2 bytes. Everyone is thinking that only limited number of characters on my keyboard, so why this is taking 2 bytes? Because on what basis the Java increase the size of character, you have to understand it properly. Basically, earlier in C and C++, character was taking only 1 byte. So if we are using 1 byte, then how many characters can be accommodated? How many characters can be accommodated? You can see 2 to the power 8, and 2 to the power 8 equal to 256 total characters. Total characters, those can be accommodated, they may be 256, but in Java 2 bytes by character means 2 to the power 16 equal to 65,536 total characters can be accommodated. Okay. So, Java can cover, because Java is platform independent, it has to work on each and every operating system. So, it is covering all the characters / alphabets of all languages, all languages at worldwide level. So at worldwide level, it will be covering approximately all the languages and all special characters, all the special characters and all the language characters or language alphabets, we can say. So, all are covered inside this one. So, this is a very interesting feature of Java, that character is taking 2 bytes, and this is known as the concept of Unicode. This is the concept of Unicode. So, today I told you about the different data types in this lecture. Now, in the next lecture, I will be telling you in which way you have to find out. Basically, you can remember all these things, but the important thing that is to be clear to every engineer, and every engineer has to know this thing, that in which way you are finding the minimum value, maximum value, or unsigned sign, in case of unsigned and signed, is to be calculated. Thank you. Please subscribe this channel, like this channel, and share this channel and share my videos. Recently, I started a series of Java. Just after some time, I am going to start the series on different languages and different technologies. So, naturally, you will be getting a lot of advantages if you are joining this channel. Thanks once again. Okay.